بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Continuing Volume 1, Riyad al-Salihin, Chapter 55, entitled Excellence of Ascetic Life. Al-Kabbab bin al-Arat radiallahu anhu reported, "We immigrated with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, seeking the pleasure of Allah and expecting our reward from Him. Some of us died without enjoying anything of it. Among them was Mus'ab bin Umair, radiallahu anhu, who was killed in the Battle of Uhud, leaving only a small colored sheet of wool, which we used as his shroud. When we covered his head with it, his feet were exposed. And when we covered his feet with it, his head was uncovered. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to cover his head and to put some izhir, a fragrant grass, over his feet. Others among us enjoyed prosperity." Bukhari and Muslim. This hadith tells us about the distinction of hijrah and jihad and their reward in this world. This reward is given to those mujahideen of Islam who gain victory and will also be given to them in al-akhirah. As for those mujahideen who get martyred on the battlefield, they will get all their rewards on the day of resurrection. Sa'd bin Sa'd radiyallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Were this world worth a wing of a mosquito, he would not have given a drink of water to the mushrikeen." This hadith makes it clear that the world and its wealth and riches has no significance to Allah. Thus, it should not have much significance to the believers. It should be considered a means to reform their afterlife or a place of trial. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The world is accursed, and what it contains is accursed, except remembrance of Allah and those who associate themselves with Allah, and a learned man and a learned person." Tirmidhi. This hadith does not mean that the world is totally condemned. What it really means is that such things of this world are cursed, which takes a person away from Allah and make him careless about his obedience. Thus, anything of this world can be good and evil. For instance, worldly goods are auspicious if one acquires them through lawful means and spends them in a permissible manner. Otherwise, they are condemnable. Similar is the case of other things in this world. 2. That knowledge is good, which brings one closer to Allah and is a source of benefit for mankind. Otherwise, it is also condemnable. 3. This hadith also brings into prominence the distinction of men of learning, especially scholars and religious disciplines.
We're still with the same chapter and talks about living a simple life, utilizing this dunya and whatever it contains to bring you closer to Allah, to have the dunya in your hand, not in your heart. And the first hadith of these three hadith of this morning about Khabbab, may Allah be pleased with him. They said that we make migration with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and our reward was with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their hijrah, their migration, their sacrifice, leaving their country, moving to another land, was only for Allah's sake. He says some of us had received part of their reward while they still here in this dunya, and some of us depart of this life without getting the reward. So we understand that the reward of the good deed can be here also, part of it. and whatever in the hereafter is much better and much greater. But it goes us to show one of the Sahaba here that when he passed away, which is Mus'ab ibn Umair, he died in the battle of Uhud. And he, this is a Sahabi, and he's a Mujahid, a person who went and gave his life for the sake of Allah. All what he have, nothing except like a sheet, piece of cloth to cover himself. And was not even have enough to cover himself, to use it as a kafan or a shroud for him, was short. So if they try to cover his whole body, if they stretch it towards the head, the feet will be exposed. If they pull it towards the feet,
the head
will be exposed. So it shows you that those people whom that Islam established on their back and they became the foundation of this deen, they did not have too much of this dunya. Okay? And this, you can see part of what made them so much focus on the hereafter, because they don't have too much to get busy with. You can see a Mujahid, he doesn't have even enough to be covered when he die. Okay? So the reward of the Muslim, it can be here as well as the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be giving the reward to some of us only in the hereafter. So don't be expecting to get the reward for everything here, or even part of it. Sometimes you don't even get anything out of it. But still, the reward and what has been saved with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much better than what we get in this life. The second hadith which he talks about the insignificant material in the sight of Allah, the whole dunya, children, buildings, money, cars, rights, and he say it has no value in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's eye. So if Allah give it to you or deprive you from it, does not mean that Allah hates you or dislike you. Because as we stated before in Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that if the dunya, that Allah if the dunya equal in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sight a wing of a mosquito, he's not going to give the kafir even a glass of water. You see how much the glass can take. And the water is everywhere, all right? But due to the fact that the dunya doesn't mean too much to Allah, the dunya that we fighting over it, boycotting one another for it, okay? Even some Muslims killing each other for it is not equal in Allah's sight, even a wing of a mosquito. And we know that we did not pay anything, not even a penny for a whole mosquito. So can you imagine a wing of a mosquito? What's the value of it? Okay? So we shouldn't be hating each other for any reason of this material thing. And what Allah gives somebody, he can give the other person. We shouldn't have hasad, jealousy, envy, hating one another. Because you understand, okay, he have this and I don't have this. Okay? He have more than me. No. We have to be content and satisfied with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us. And know that Allah can give us as much as he gives the other brother or even more. So why we don't turn to Allah and ask Allah instead of being jealous from each other and fighting each other, and they try, understand, to go and they get what somebody else have it, in not lawful means. So we have to understand that this dunya and the material thing is a test for us. So we shouldn't be depriving ourselves from the love of Allah and the love of our brothers and sisters because some of this material thing. The last hadith that it shows you about ad-dunya and whatever in the dunya is a distance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy, with exception of alim, scholar, or a seeker of knowledge, okay? And the remembrance of Allah and whatever relate to the remembrance of Allah. So that means make your main focus about this. Be a scholar. If you could not be a scholar, at least be a student of knowledge. But don't leave yourself to be with the people who's walking in the street like have no value for them. Always they care about eating and sleeping and playing and having games and things like this. Be a scholar. Okay? So you get out of the curse. If you could not be a scholar, so be a student of knowledge. Okay? Be a student of the knowledge. Seek the knowledge. What else? He said, Dhikrullah, the remembrance of Allah, or anything related to the remembrance of Allah. Like what we say, what we doing. Reading Quran, making dhikr, learning hadith, learning the Arabic alphabet so you can be able to read the Quran. Anything related to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, we have to understand that purpose of this dunya and whatever in it to be a means for us to get closer to Allah. So not to waste our time of trying getting more for our own selfish needs and wants. No, but we do things, you understand, whatever in this dunya that we can, that to realize it in getting closer to Allah. Not to the dunya to be fitna for us, to take us away from the remembrance of Allah, to take us away from serving the deen of Allah, to take us away from establishing our Muslim community and our Muslim institution. Okay? The Muslims are in very bad shape, in need, especially in a country like this, where they are minority. They don't have their institutions. Okay? As a result of this, they found their children, they're going to public school, they're socializing with non-Muslims day and night. As a result of this, you see, most of the children of the Muslim are lost, totally lost. A great number of the children of Muslims, they are in jails, okay, or they are in the street, boys and girls, and this is fact. This is a reality. Most of the children of the Muslims, they are in the street or are in jail or someplace Allah knows best where they are. So we have to see how much we can use our money, our time, our resources, our intelligence to help to bring the Muslim together, to try to create alternatives for them, for their children. They will have their own places to serve their own community because the environment has too much impact, especially on the youngest among us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this life, inshallah, whatever in it, to be a means and ways that to be able to establish the deen of Allah. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu
ilayk. Question.
Yes.
What's the word? I see it in all the books I read. I forgot to look it up in the dictionary.
Ascetic?
Ascetic.
Zuhd, not to fall in love in the dunya. Living a simple life. Do you have anybody can give a better translation?
No.
Without looking in the phone?
Oh, that's it.
Okay.
Look in the phone.
Live with whatever you understand, what simple life, what
within your means.
Within your means, because when you try to, you understand, to see this, you have a bigger car than me, you have a better house than me, and you don't have the means, you're going to start with then getting in the haram, you understand, getting in usury, spending too much time, understand, away from your family and your kids, because your focus is getting more and more and more. Some people, they change in their living rooms, you understand, the couch and the furniture, maybe twice a year.
Every 6 months.
Okay, every 6 months. So this is what we're talking about. Like I said, I think was Abu Dharr, when some of the Sahaba visited him in his house, no couch, no anything, like a piece of mat, you understand, or on the floor. They say, where is your furniture? They said, I send it before me to my other house. Which other house is talking about? There, waiting for me there. This is not my house. Here is temporary place. You understand? This was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, be in this dunya like a stranger. If you want to know what is static life, live in the dunya as if you are a stranger. Okay? This is what it is. Don't be so much familiar with this and that and this and that. I want this, I want. Okay. Nothing wrong with 95 model Mazda or whatever, Datsun or Cadillac, whatever, you understand? Brother, 95, everybody now driving, you understand, 2005 and going up. Why worry about everybody else? You get a reliable car, take you from a place to place, so be grateful. Some other people did not have even a car, did not have even moped. But keep, you understand, looking up to other people, what they have, and we try to be matching to them for no other reason, you understand, only for me. This is the problem. Now you are not living what you call aesthetic. How we say aesthetic?
Aesthetic life.
Aesthetic life.
At the times of the companions, may Allah keep them in Jannah for good. We are 1,000 times more tested than they are, brother man, because of the materialistic life.
You don't know, brother, this statement is very heavy, understand? They've been tested with fear, hunger. They have to fight.
Well, I'm talking about the materialistic life.
Everybody have his own test in a different ways. Okay, we may say that the dunya been flourished to us more than their time.
Yeah,
this is fact.
Yeah.
But they have their own test.
Yeah.
They have temptations there.
Yeah.
They have the khamr there.
Yeah.
They have the women there.
Yeah, yeah.
They have, you understand,
the gold, the money.
Okay,
yeah.
This is what Allah said in the Quran, so, you know, in this, لِنَا لِنَسْ حُبُّ الشَّوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ وَالْبَنَاتِ وَالْقَنَاطِيرُ مُقَنْطَرَةِ. So, it's been beautified to the people, the material of the things they understand, and the luxury of this life, from women, and they start to count until the horses, so we have the cars, they have horses, but the basic fitna is always there.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. May Allah help us all.
Yes. Is that the same thing as being like a hermit or being like a monk or something?
It's some almost close, because usually what you call monks in this time, I don't know if they have it these days or not. A person who's basically in some place, distant from everybody, his main focus about the prayer and the worship of Allah, and this it, okay? But we mingle with the Muslims, we try to serve the Muslims, but with what is basic enough for us to make it, okay? Without losing our focus, inshallah.
Bilal.
Okay, this is what you're talking about, people who don't want to get married. Okay, this is not rahbaniya. Okay, to be deprive yourself from certain pleasures of this life with assumption that this will bring you closer to Allah. So some people will say, I'm not going to marry anymore. I'm not going to eat meat anymore because this will bring me closer to Allah. This is what we're talking about. Okay? Allah knows this. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك